So here we shall be taking a simple task to be implemented into the MATLAB environment here. So we name it with the start MATLAB program to illustrate the performance of quadrature mirror filter. So let us switch to the MATLAB environment. Now, as we know that the quadrature mirror filter can be designed with the help of various ways. There are many kind of QMF filters or filter banks you can see here. So a typical one example we are going to select here. So let us first of all comment what exactly we are going to deal with. So here we are going to write a MATLAB program. So this is a program where we are going to plot the responses so that the performance evaluation can be obtained here. So program for, as we are going to plot the responses and that too into the frequency domain. So I shall be writing frequency responses of, frequency responses of QMF filters. So the filter that we are going to deal with in this particular MATLAB program is sometimes also referred by Johnston's filter that you can find into the standard textbooks here. So this is the QMF filter, and here we shall be entering the prototype low pass filter coefficient first of all to start with. So we separate out that particular script to initialize with the coefficients of low pass filter. So whatever the problems with respect to the QMF filters you can find into the standard textbook, you can accept the coefficients that have been computed by the design of those filters and provide it as input to this particular program here. So now for accepting such an input, which is the coefficient of the design filter here, we shall be initiating with the variable capital P1 here. So to the variable capital P1, we shall be assigning the value with the help of MATLAB command input. So that will take the value from command prompt here, and onto the command prompt, initially after the execution of this program, it will print the syntax string here to enter the filter coefficients. Equal to sign. So this command can be ended with the help of semicolon. Now for the obtained input values from the command prompt for the same variable B1, we are going to arrange the values into the array form, as we are taking the B1 values as it is, and the same number of elements we are getting clipped left to right, right to left, whatever you can. So for that purpose, we have the MATLAB syntax. So as we are going to clip the values here, so those values are onto the left will be onto the right, and the right side elements will be onto the left side here. So I mention it the command clip LR. So clip left right, and to this MATLAB syntax, we provide the input B1 that we have just now accepted as the input from the above step here. So this is what we are initializing for the coefficients of low pass filter. Now after this, we require another complementary high pass filter also. So let us separate out the script for the same with the help of comment line here. So here I shall be mention generation of the complementary high pass filter. Now for this complementary high pass filter to be generated here, we require the specific filter length here. So to have the filter length, we take capital L as the variable, and this filter length should be equal to the length that we have just now defined for the variable B1 with the original elements we have obtained from the command prompt and appending to that the clipped version for left to right sign of the same elements here. So the length shall be getting doubled here. So here for capital L, we are going to make the assignment with the help of MATLAB syntax length here. So to this length, we provide the input variable capital T1 here. Now the filter is to be designed. So for this particular filter, we take the help of for loop for formulation. So for for loop, we define intermediate variable small k, the index variable, and that can be initiated at the value 1 and can range up to capital L, that is the length of capital B1, the first filter. So now for this much of value of small k, we are going to formulate the high pass filter by the name B2, and B2 of k, the intermediate index variable we have been using, is formulated by, here we are going to have the assignment of within the parenthesis -1, and which is provided the power by k here, and this is in multiplication to, we have B1, the first filter, and in the bracket we are providing k as the index here. So ending this particular syntax line with the help of semicolon. So now the task is completed for the for loop. So for loop should be ended here. So for the values of small k, starting at 1 up to the complete length of B1 filter, we have all this formulation, the corresponding values have been computed, and it will be residing with the variable B2 now. So now we have the two filters. So corresponding to these two filters, those will be a part of the quadrature mirror filter. We have to plot the gains. We have to first of all obtain the gains and then plot them. So here I shall be separating the MATLAB script module. So here I shall be mentioning to compute the gain responses of the two filters that we have just now worked with, that we have initiated or generated here. So for this computation purpose, as to hold the responses, we require the two variables as we are working into the frequency domain. So for first filter, we are going to have the variable h1z and another variable w to represent the frequency domain, and to these variables the assignment of the values shall be made by the frequency response as we are usually obtaining with the help of MATLAB syntax FREQ set here. Now as this is for the first filter, we shall be providing it the input by capital B1 comma 1 comma, here we are having 256 as the input parameters here. Now from these variables, the two variables that we have obtained, we require the absolute value of the h variable, and from that absolute value the gain value can be formulated here. So let us have the formulation of small h1. So small h1 can be absolute of the MATLAB syntax ABS, providing capital h1 instead, as into the transform domain we have used capital H here. And then the decibel values into the gain. So for first filter, I shall be making a variable capital G1. So into the decibels, the value can be obtained by taking the logarithm and in multiplication to the amplitude 20 here. So here we shall be making the assignment 20 asterisk log to the base 10 of the variable is h1 that just now we have opted into above step here. So this way we have obtained the gain corresponding to the first filter. Now we have to obtain the gain corresponding to the second filter that we have also generalized here, that we have also generated here. So for the second filter, we again require the two variables corresponding to the frequency domain. So here we are going to have the result obtained by the variable h2z here, comma w is the variable into the frequency domain. Now the assignment shall be again by syntax freq z to obtain the frequency response, and as this is for the second filter here, second filter is designated by the variable capital B2 here, along with capital B2 1,256 we are providing as input here. Continuation of the topic. So now we have obtained the frequency response corresponding to the second filter that we have designed here. Now with respect to the second filter, the gain responses we have to first of all compute and then plot here. So for the gain responses from the variables capital H2, so for the variables that now we have obtained capital H2Z, comma W, W to represent the frequency domain here. So here we shall be requiring the computation as small h2. So small h2 can be obtained as the absolute value of capital H2Z value. And now as we require the gain to be computed and then further plotted into the decibels here, we have to take the logarithm form here. So for the logarithm form here, we are making a multiplication of 20 to the logarithm of, here inside we are providing small h2 as the variable, and this formulation can be assigned to the variable small h2 here, small g2 here. So the assignment we have made to the small g2. So this way small g1 and small g2, these are the two variables corresponding to the gains of the two filters here. Now it's a task to have plotting here. So for plotting, I just mention a comment, plotting the gain responses of the two filters. So for plotting purpose, the simple command is plot here. So plot plot is the command. And now in this particular plot, we are providing the input variables as W divided by pi. So this is the representation of the frequency domain here, comma, here we are providing the values of the first filter gain. That is why G1 here. Next to that, we are also required to plot corresponding gain values of the filter 2 here. So that is why here we provide first of all a dash within a pair of single quotes, and again we are going to have W by pi plotted against the value of gain for second filter, that is why G2 here. After that, we can have the double dashes within the single quotes here, and all this plot we want in the grid form. So by the next line, we can provide labels to the axis here. So I just mentioned x label for the x axis. Here we shall be assigning the representation of slash omega to print the omega symbol here, and that is divided by pi. In the formulation we have already made it, so in the printing part should also be same here. So ending this with the help of semicolon, now naming the y axis here. So the command is y label, and here upon we are going to have the display of gain values, hence writing the gain, and the gain is mentioned in terms of decibels, hence small d capital V is the representation of the unit here. So as this is just the plot of the gain responses, along with the gain responses we have also to plot the distortion corresponding distortions into the amplitude levels here. So here to this particular plot we shall be taking first of all a pause to display the gain responses, and after pressing any of the key from the keyboard, the corresponding amplitude distortion can be displayed into the same plot here. So for that purpose, to the next line I shall be mentioning the MATLAB command pause, and then I shall be separating out with the comment line where I shall be write to compute the sum of the squared magnitude responses. So here the sum for the magnitudes that we have obtained with the variables H1 and H2, and into the decibels we have made it to G1 and P2. So for the sum we shall be taking for loop here. So for loop we have the index variable I that can be initiated at the value 1 up to 256, as we have utilized in the formulation of the filters, the low pass as well as the complementary high pass here. So in this for loop, as the result we are expecting to be a sum, we write the variable to the output to be SVM sum. Here we shall be having the index variable I assigned to it, and it can be having computed by the mathematical logic. Here we shall be writing the addition. So within parenthesis here we have first of all small h1 of I in multiplication to again h1 of I. So this will be square. The multiplication of the same term with itself will give us square here, and this is added to, as we require the sum, to the corresponding values of the gain for second filter. So here we shall be mentioning h2 of I in multiplication to again h2 of I here. So this is ended, and the sum will be accomplished for all the values 1 to 256. Hence I complete the for loop with the syntax end here. So now the distortion is to be computed. So we know the formulation of distortion, and the distortion can be computed in terms of decibels by having first of all 10 in multiplication to the log to the base 10 for the sum that just now we have computed with respect to the skewers. So I mentioned SVM sum as a variable to input for the logarithm representation. So now this is the computation of distortion. We have assigned the distortion value to small d as a variable, and this distortion is to be now graphically plotted. So for that purpose, I mention here, plot the amplitude of, or plot the amplitude distortion for above cases or above filters. So hereupon, for plotting purpose, as we have plotted the gains here, we are again having the plot command. And now this time the input variables are, we require W divided by pi, comma, this time there is no gain, only the distortions, hence the variable is small d here. We want this plot into the grid form, so GRID grid, and by the next line, here we shall provide nomenclature to the axis of this particular plot here. So to the x-axis, we shall be making x label into the use. So within a pair of single quotes, we shall be expecting the symbol of omega to represent the frequency domain. So slash omega, here we have in use, divided by the pi symbol is to be also printed. So slash pi is to be utilized here. In the similar fashion, y-axis can be named by y-label. And to this y-label, here we specify the string to be printed, that is amplitude distortion. And as this distortion is computed in terms of decibels, we also specify the unit of measurement, that is small d capital B for distortion here. So this way the MATLAB script is completed here. Now it's time to get this particular program saved here. So let us name it by program2_19. We save it. Yes, the name has been changed to the editor tab here, as well as the file has been created into the current directory. So this is a MATLAB script for demonstration of frequency responses of the QMF filters here. So now we can execute this program. So as we execute this particular program, you can see the command window is having a syntax that has been displayed there. It is mentioning enter the filter coefficients. So let us enter the filter coefficients. So as the coefficients are array in the form, here we specify them with the help of square bracket. So let us have certain positive values, that I get 12, 34, 56, 78, 23, then 87, then 13, and now hitting the enter. So as I hit the enter, now first of all we have been provided the gain values corresponding to the filters here. So whatever the input values we have specified from the command prompt, these values 12, 34, 56, 78, 23, 87, 13 are the filter coefficients, and that have been assigned to the capital P1 here. The next step of the program, you can remember the elements of P1. So these are the 7 elements and the flip LR version. So the flipped version, so right hand side variables will be on to the left hand side variables elements will be on to the right hand side. So the mirror effect will be there. So here we have initially the 7 elements, so the total 14 elements shall be there with the variable P1. The computation of the gains correspondingly will be having, and now here we have the plot here. So on to the horizontal axis, we have the representation, as this is the frequency response, omega divided by pi, and it has ranged from 0 to 1 here. Now the scale we can know right from 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 0.9 and finally up to 1 here. The gains, we have a plot right from minus 20 decibels to 140 decibels. Now you can see the plot with the help of two colors here. So one is with the blue line, another is with the dashed red line here. So the corresponding drop down points you can notice for blue line, we have the gain value, that is 14.66 decibels. Here we have 2.697. Here we have minus 0.07506 value, and at this point here we have the value 13.67. In the second case we have the values minus 0.1728, here we have 6.209, and now at this point we have 33.76. so this is the plot with respect to the gain. Now we have to press any of the key onto the keyboard so that the distortion levels for the given input can be printed here. So now you can see the change into the same MATLAB window. Now onto the horizontal axis, the scale is the same from 0 to 1 corresponding to omega by pi values here, with the same difference level 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 0.9 and finally at 1. But onto the vertical axis, instead of having the gains plotted, we have the plot of amplitude distortion computed into the decibels. So right from 25, 30, 35 up to 60 decibels we have the scale here. And here you can see the combined effect of amplitude distortion that we have computed by having the summation of the squares here. So this is the particular graph we have obtained for the specified values here. So I just close this window, run this again. So whatever the problems you have from the textbook, standard textbook, the obtained coefficients for the QMF filters we can provide as input here. So I am here first of all providing the random values. So in the previous case I have used all the positive values here. This time I start with, let us say, minus 78, then we can have 56, then minus 32, then we have 40, 45, then 79, minus 10. So three coefficient values we are providing with the negation and rest of with the positive cases here. Continuation of the topic. So hitting the enter, we are obtaining a MATLAB window, and in this MATLAB window again you have the two plots here corresponding to the blue line, the continuous line here, and a dashed line by the red color here. So here we have a plot of gain. The values you can note to be, for the blue, the first one 5.028, here it is 5.765, this one at 20.07. For the another case, here we have 44.46, 13.27 and 11.58. So as we require to have the amplitude distortion plotted here, so here we have this particular plot obtained here. So on the vertical axis, the amplitude distortion is ranging from 36 to 54. So in that scale, here we have the values. So this is with respect to the summation of both the filter cases here. So 37.71 distortion that has been pointed out at this particular location in this plot. At this point here we have 37.91. The peaks here we have to 53.52 and here also at 53.57. So this is what corresponding to the quadrature mirror filter.